Gabriel, an angel loyal to God, fought against the falling spirits. One of the fallen, the angel of light, believed that whoever possessed the ruby would have great power between heaven and earth. However, a human soul was also needed. One deformed with a heart of selfishness and vanity. Through this soul, the ruby could bestow godlike powers upon the fallen to rule over man. As the legend goes, there in a small African village lived a young boy named Ngozi, who had lost his parents to a terrible plague. This boy and his youngest sister were the only ones from their family to survive the plague. All alone, they searched for other survivors, walking miles and miles in the hot desert sun way into the night. Dehydrated and parched, starving for food and water, their bodies finally collapsed. Struggling to survive and pulling himself forward just a few more feet, the young boy's hand stuck something hard in the hot burning sand. He sifted it out with his fingers. Lo and behold, it was the red ruby of power. With merely a touch, the young boy and his sister drew strength from the magnificent red ruby. As the night got filled with beautiful colors of glittering lights from fireflies, dancing in harmony, as their wings fluttered with musical sound. The young boy and his sister stood there in amazement when the ruby leaped from its hand and moved over their heads. The clouds in the sky parted, and a radiant beam of light shined down on the boy and his sister. A thunderous voice came from the ruby itself, as if an oracle, proclaiming the boy to be a great ruler who would change the destinies of many people. As the light dimmed, as the voice faded, the red ruby told the young boy to keep his prediction a secret for his own safety and that of his sister.